Today I'm starting some major upgrades on my CNC router. Upgrades that I've needed to do for literally years now, and I'm finally getting around to them because the machine's making me. This big upgrade I'm looking at doing is the 2.2 kilowatt spindle. These things are all over the internet. They've got some annoying little nuances about them when you get them, but they work great. There's a ton of power to be made with them, and lots of really great stuff can be done with them. I chose to go with the air-cooled version. I'm kind of regretting it. I went with it because I didn't want to deal with coolant like I had to deal with on my laser. The whole reason I wanted to go with the spindle, though, was because of noise reduction, because I'm currently running a router, and my shop's directly underneath my kid's room. What I found was the air-cooled version isn't much quieter than a router, because it's still using air to cool the spindle. So I'll probably be looking at changing out to a water-cooled version and running the plumbing a little later. Another annoying thing about them is the most commonly available collets for this thing are metric. And I live in the USA. My huge stock of carbide tooling that I've got, I can't use with the metric collets that I bought. That's annoying. So I just went and bought another $50 in collets so I can use all my tooling. Fun fact. None of these come with collet wrench. Your 20 collet nut is 30 millimeters, which is a huge wrench if you just go out to Lowe's or Home Depot or something and buy a wrench. The nice part about the collet nut is, if you were so inclined, you could use a crescent wrench. On the spindle, you have a 21 millimeter clamp right here that's super thin. So you can't use a normal box end wrench, and for some reason 21 millimeter wrenches are really hard to find. So later I'm going to be doing a video where I'm going to actually mill out a 21 millimeter wrench for the spindle on my G0704 mill. What I'm going to be doing is the current long axis on my machine, my x-axis, is chain drive. And the chain drive is very similar to the chain drive that Build Your CNC uses. It works okay, but I've been running this chain drive hard for 4 years now. Updating to rack and pinion and using the CNC router parts rack and pinion carriage and making a plate to adapt it to my CNC. Another fun thing that I'm planning on doing is I'm currently running Linux CNC on my CNC router. Love Linux CNC. Linux CNC got me into Linux and got me into all kinds of other fun things. And I'm not going away from Linux CNC, but I got this sweet little Gerber board to test from one of my favorite companies who, until they give me permission to tell who made this, will be unnamed. And it's got some monster little driver carriers on it, and I'm really excited to try them out. Because everything that's kept me from going to with anything like Gerber or Smoothie until now is I run big motors, and my motors need about 4 amps. I think they can take up to 4.2 amps. Well, these little tiny driver carriers on here are capable of 4.0 amps, so we're going to see how they work. We'll see how this video turns out. All right, thanks.